video, NY Times lies about Trump's Asia trip, POTUS shuts up naive haters with three words. The mainstream media has been lying about President Donald Trump's historic trip to Asia since day one, with the New York Times being one of the worst offenders. On Wednesday, after having had enough of the misrepresentation, Trump unleashed his fury on the liberal outlet, effectively shutting up his naive haters with just three simple words. President Donald Trump returned to Washington, D.C., late Tuesday after a whirlwind overseas trip to Asia which lasted nearly 2 weeks and saw POTUS travel to five Pacific Rim nations to speak with foreign leaders. He attended bilateral meetings, made speeches, and negotiated a number of deals that will help put the United States ahead in the global economy. "Our great country is respected again in Asia," Trump tweeted after returning stateside. "You will see the fruits of our long but successful trip for many years to come," he added. Indeed, the president was able to accomplish more in less than 2 weeks in Asia than his predecessor did in 8 years. Although it is widely known that Trump's trip was a resounding success, the mainstream media has been hard at work twisting the story to paint the president in a negative light. "One of the worst culprits that we have seen when it comes to biased reporting surrounding the Trump administration is the New York Times. President Trump is sick and tired of outlets like the NIN lying about him," so on Wednesday, he took to Twitter in his usual fashion to condemn the purveyor of fake news, calling the publisher weak and ineffective. "The failing at New York Times hates the fact that I have developed a great relationship with world leaders like Xi Jinping, president of China," Trump tweeted. "They should realize that these relationships are a good thing, not a bad thing," he added. "The U.S. is being respected again. Watch trade," Trump went on. "It is actually hard to believe how naive, or dumb, the failing at New York Times is when it comes to foreign policy. Weak and ineffective," he concluded, much to the delight of his supporters, who have also watched in dismay as the president is attacked day in and day out by the NIT and others. President Donald Trump also took a shot at CNN, which repeatedly slanted their coverage of his Asia trip. "While in the Philippines I was forced to watch at CNN, which I have not done in months, and again realized how bad, and fake, it is. Loser," the president tweeted, leaving no question as to how he feels about the network. President Trump's historic trip throughout Asia unfolded flawlessly. From the great honor bestowed upon him in China when he and the First Lady were invited to dine in the Forbidden City, to his speech at the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation, APEC, summit, both he and Melania represented America in a way that should make every U.S. citizen proud. One need only to look as far as the news media from other countries, which has had nothing but positive remarks about the Trumps, to know that their Asia trip was a success. However, it is unfortunate that the American mainstream media is still desperately trying to sabotage President Trump in any way possible 1 year after his election. This is particularly concerning for the citizens who still rely on our biased press to get their news. Will they ever give Trump the credit he is due? I wouldn't hold my breath if I were you.